Best greetings of the time to all of you. I am Mr. Shashikant B. Gosavi, Assistant Professor, Department of Civil Engineering, Walchand Institute of Technology. Today I am presenting the online educational resource on production rate of earthmoving equipment. The learning outcomes of this online educational resource are, at the end of this session, the learners will be able to analyze the production rate of earth moving equipment. The second learning outcome is calculate, the learner will be able to calculate the productivity rate for completing the work of earth moving equipments. You can see the picture and feel how complex are the activities happening onto the site. You can see the time printed at the bottom over there. At 7:22 a.m. the work starts, and then at 7:47, the activities start rolling in with proper daylight. It will be almost on the flag end of completion by around 4:58 p.m. and then the work will be winded up. In many cases, along with this, you will also have the diesel energy systems to help you to work even in the dark hours. You can see that there are plenty of equipment. There is an excavator which is working, there is a loader, there are several workers which are working onto the site, there are dozers which are spreading the respective material, there are dump trucks, and then there are several activities which are happening all over the place. The analysis of the production rate is the aim of this OER, and the operational analysis of selected type of equipment is utmost essential. There are seven major activities of earthwork which will be considered, like clearing and grubbing, which is always the first activity, followed by excavating. Then there will be loading of the material which is excavated. There will be hauling, transportation of the material from the work site to dump site and vice versa. There will be backfilling in some of the cases, there will be grading in some of the cases, and in some of the cases there will be a need of the compaction also, and therefore lot many equipments will also be coming into the picture. The productivity rate comprises of following main steps, like data collection for any site. When you are moving ahead for the analysis of the production rate, you need to know very well the site topography. You need to know the soil characteristics that the respective earth moving equipment is going to handle, and you need to have clear idea about which equipments are being employed onto the site. The numerical analysis of earth moving operations, such as travel distance, particularly for the hauling, rolling resistance to the respective a maneuvering system, it may be on the wheels or it may be on some other base, and most importantly, you need to have the idea of cycle time. Further, we need to determine productivity rates based on the user input parameters. In order to conduct the analysis, the user input consists of following database. Equipment type is one important thing. The capacity of that particular equipment is required to be known well in advance. Several specifications are known to are supposed to be known. Site topography and the topographical features is another important thing which the analyst has to give the consideration to, and the material characteristic is very, very important, particularly in regard to fragmentation and moisture content and cohesion, adhesion, and so many things. The equipment productivity rate are calculated based on soil characteristics, site topography, and volume of earth moving. While satisfying these particular equipment constraints, such as rolling resistance, maximum rim pull, and horsepower capacities, these are important to be considered when you proceed further for the productivity rate analysis. The operational analysis of the equipment has two constraints, as we have spoken earlier. The first constraint is defined as the loaded weight. The loaded weight must not exceed the maximum allowable weight set by the manufacturer. In addition to that, this constraint of loaded weight is expressed by using LW, which should be less than or equal to RW, where LW is the loaded weight and RW is the rated weight. The rated weight is normally in the equipment manufacturer's information. The second constraint is defined as the total resistance. The total resistance must not exceed the allowable rim pull or drawbar if the equipment is wheel mounted or crawler mounted respectively. Rim pull is particularly applicable for the wheel mounted and drawbar are corresponding to the crawler mounted. And therefore, TR has to be less than RP and TR has to be less than DB is another constraint, where TR is the total resistance. RP is allowable rim pull for the wheels, or if it is the crawler mounted, then DB is the allowable drawbar. The operational parameters are categorized into four main groups. The first one of that is spatial relationship, which includes several parameters like topography, obstruction in earth excavation, clearance heights, required heights, required reach maneuverability, and location of hauling units. The second parameter is soil characteristics like rolling and grade resistance, which provides traction and soil stability, potential changes in the characteristics during performance of the work, required force to loosen material, need for ripping and pushing attachments and abrasiveness, and other rough earth qualities such as rock material that may cause problems in equipment. The third parameter is contract provisions. Quality of the earth involved as well as quantity of earth involved are equally important. Time constraints and weather conditions are required. Requirement for payment and subsequent cash flows is another important factor. Legal constraints on the weight and size of equipment is something which is required to be known to us. Other restrictions such as traffic, hours, dust and noise also influence the operational parameters. The last one is the logistical considerations. It involves availability of required equipment and operator, mobilizing and demobilizing time, use of equipment in preceding operations and idle time, economical equipment cost and support facilities. If we will go for the calculation of the productivity rates, these are determined based on equipment specifications, data and specific parameters related to location. Productivity rate is equal to volume multiplied by operational efficiency divided by cycle time. Very simple formula, where volume is actually required amount of earth moving operations, which is in cubic meters. Operational efficiency is minute per hour, and cycle time, the time needed to complete an earth moving operation, which is the total of fixed and variable time and includes the time needed for completing one cycle while being empty and loaded depending on the type of equipment. Please pause the video for a while and answer following question. What will be the unit of productivity rate? Just in the previous slide, we have seen the formula. In the formula, there were some datas. Each of them were supposed to have some units, and you are supposed to answer this question. See, the productivity rate is actually based on volume, operational efficiency and cycle time in the relation as has been shown over here. Volume is in cubic meter, which is in numerator here. Operating efficiency is in minute per hour and cycle time is in hour. So if we will put the unit of volume, operational efficiency and cycle time, you can easily understand that unit of productivity rate will be cubic meter per hour. I have used this Nizar, Marquis and Ahmed grid and integrated expert system for linear scheduling heavy earth moving operation as a reference, which comes from Journal of Construction Engineering, Volume 2016, Article 2312057. Thank you very much.